Hello student, today we'll discuss about the factors affecting on the performance of the simple VCRS. This topic is covered in the unit number 3, that is the refrigeration in thermal engineering 2 subject. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to know the effect of subcooling, effect of condenser pressure, effect of the evaporator pressure on the performance of the simple VCRS. Now, first is the effect of subcooling. Before going into the effect of the subcooling, we need to understand the pH diagram. We already discussed the pH diagram in the earlier lecture. As we know that in the pH diagram, that is a pressure enthalpy diagram, this line is known as a saturated liquid line, and this line is known as a saturated vapor line. This 1 to 2 process is known as a compression process, 2 to 3 is a condensation, 3 to 4 is the expansion process, and 4 to 1 is a evaporator process. In the 4 to 1, the refrigerating effect is produced. This one is a W compressor, that is the compressor work. In this pH diagram, this region is known as subcooled region, that is on the left side of the saturated liquid line. So that region is known as a subcooled region. This region is known as a superheated vapor region, that is on the right side of the saturated vapor line, that is a green line on the right side, superheated vapor. In between, the region is known as a liquid plus vapor, or you can say that is a wet region. So now, what is the effect of the subcooling on the performance of the VCRS? COP is increasing, COP is decreasing, or it's remain the constants? That we need to understand in the effect of the subcooling. Now, to carry out the subcooling, we need to shift the point 3 on the left side, that is on the third left side, 3 dash. So first, 1 to 2 compressor is remain, the compression work is remain the same, 2 to 3 is the condensation. Now we are doing the subcooling. Subcooling means we are cooling the refrigerant with the help of the extra amount of the water or by using the low temperature working medium for the cooling. So this 3 point gets subcool and it is shifted on the left side, that is a 3 dash. We are not changing any condenser pressure, we are not changing any suction pressure, so this line and this line remain the same. Just we are doing the subcooling by having the extra amount of the water or by lowering the temperature of the same water which is used for the condensation process. So this 3 point will be shifted on the left side, that is 3 dash. And after that, we are carrying out the expansion process. So 3 dash to 4 dash is the same expansion process. And there will be the evaporation, that is 4 to 1 is the refrigerating effect or evaporation process. So this cycle has been changed. This one is the red cycle is known as a simple VCRS, that is 1, 2, 3, and 4. And by doing the subcooling, 2 new points is generated, that is 3 dash and 4 dash. That is, new cycle will be now 1, 2, 3 dash and 4 dash with the subcooling. Now we need to understand whether the COP is increasing, COP is decreasing, or it's remain the constant when we are doing the subcooling. So in this case, first we will identify which region is a refrigerating effect. So we know that this one is region is known as a refrigerating effect. This is the W compressor, as we already discussed. Now, by doing the subcooling, we are not changing any pressure. So W compression work, that is H2 minus H1, is remain the constant. We already discussed in the earlier lectures. So W compressor H2 minus H1 remain the constant. Now simple VCRS. In the simple VCRS, refrigerating effect is H1 minus H4. Refrigerating effect is H1 minus H4. Now, by doing the subcooling, the now refrigerating effect is change. So H1 minus H4, because 4 point is shifted into the 4 dash by doing the subcooling, that is H1 minus H4 dash. So what is the effect? Refrigerating effect is increasing because we are having the more refrigerating, that is a blue line is there. So we will have the more refrigerating effect in the by doing the subcooling. Now what is COP? COP we know that refrigerating effect divided by W compressor. So in this case we are having the more refrigerating effect in the cycle of the subcooling. So here sub refrigerating effect is increasing. So whole COP will be increasing. So it is advisable by for doing the subcooling we will have the more COP. So COP is increased by doing the subcooling. So one of the important parameter or one of the important factor is that when we have the subcooling in the any cycle or simple VCRS cycle, we will have the more COP. So subcooling is advisable. Now that is COP is increased by doing the subcooling. Now effect of the condenser pressure, or it is known as a discharge pressure. So this line is evaporator pressure. This line is known as a condenser pressure. So what is the change in the COP when we will change the condenser pressure? That is our objective of this discussion. So we are changing the condenser pressure. We are using the more pressure of the refrigerant. That is 2 point is shifted on the 2 dash. So that is a high pressure condenser it is used. So in this case, the pH diagram has been changed. That is 2 to 3 dash is the condensation because we are changing the pressure. Then the expansion will be carried out and there will be the evaporation of the particular refrigerant. That is, this one is a refrigerating effect. So now in this case, what is the refrigerating effect and what is the W compressor that we need to understand? So in this region, what is the simple VCRS? What is the W compressor and what is the refrigerating effect? So W compressor, as we know that in the simple, that is on the red cycle, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, that is without changing the condenser pressure. So in this case, W compressor is H2 minus H1. This is the W compressor work, H2 minus H1. And refrigerating effect is H1 minus H4. So there is a refrigerating effect, H1 minus H4. So now when we change the condenser pressure, this 2 point is shifted on the higher side, that is higher pressure we are using right now. So 2 dash, 3 dash, and 4 dash. So 1, 2 dash, 3 dash, and 4 dash is the new cycle for when we change the condenser pressure. So in this case, W compressor is now H2 dash minus H1. And in the case of refrigerating effect also change, that is H1 minus H4 dash, H1 minus H4 dash. So by analyzing what is the change in the refrigerating effect and what is the change in the W compressor. So in this case, W compressor is increased because we are having the high pressure. So more compression work is required. So W compressor is increased and refrigerating effect is decreased. So because 3 to 4 dash, it is already seen in the diagram. 1 to 4 line is having the higher line and 1 to 4 dash is a smaller line. So refrigerating effect is decreased and W compressor is increased. So that is the effect of the condenser pressure on the refrigerating effect and W compressor. Now what is change in the COP? So in the case of the COP, we are having the reduction in the COP. The reason is that we are losing the refrigerating effect. We are giving the more work, but we are getting the less COP because this numerator is decreasing and W compressor denominator is increasing. So we will have the decreasing in the COP when we change the condenser pressure. So it is advisable to use the proper condenser pressure to run the simple VCRS cycle. So by doing the high pressure or by changing the condenser pressure, we will have the COPs decreases. That is the effect on the performance of the simple VCRS. That is COPs decreases. Now effect of the evaporator pressure, or another name is known as a suction pressure. So in that case, this is a simple pH diagram 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to check on the, or I want to analyze 1 to 4. I want to change the evaporator pressure and want to analyze what is the effect. So in this case, the 1 point is shifted on the downside. I am reducing the evaporator pressure and then analyze what is the change in the COP of the particular VCRS cycle. So the cycle has been changed. That is 1 to 2 dash is a compression work, 2 to 3 is a condensation, and I want to do more expansion, that is 3 to 4 dash, because the evaporator pressure is lowering. So the expansion is also having the higher, that is 3 to 4 dash, and there will be the evaporator process 4 dash to 1 dash. So what is the effect of the evaporator pressure that we need to analyze? As we know that in the simple VCRS, W compressor work is, this is the simple red color pH diagram, 1, 2, 3, 4. So W compressor will be H2 minus H1, that is the W compressor. RE is H1 minus H4, that is the H1 minus H4. And in the case of the changing the evaporator's pressure, the new cycle is 1 dash, 2 dash, and 3 is remaining the same, and new 4 point is generated, that is a 4 dash. That is a new VCRS by doing the changing the condenser pressure. So in this case, W compressor is H2 dash minus H1 dash, more compressor work. RE slightly reduced because this curve is, in the changing in this way, having the curvature. So slightly refrigerating effect is also affected. So new RE will be H1 dash minus H4 dash. So what is the effect RE and W compressor? RE is reduced, slightly it is reduced. This is the amount of the, because of the curvature of the saturated vapor line, this RE is reduced, and it is already visible that W compressor is also increasing, because 1 to 2 is this one simple, and we are lowering the evaporator pressure, we will have the more compressor work. So W compressor is 1 to 2 dash. So W compressor ma vadharo thai chhe, 1 to 2 dash. W compressor is higher. So what is the effect on COP? COP is refrigerating effect divided by W compressor. So refrigerating effect is reduced because W compressor increase and refrigerating effect is also decreased. So we will not have the COP in the higher side. We will have the reduction in the COP. So what I'm trying to say, the COP is decreases. The main point is then when you are lowering the evaporator pressure, the COP is decreasing. This is the condenser. This is not a condenser. This is one evaporator pressure. Now, also another effect is also important, that is superheating. In the superheating, we are changing the point 1 to 2 dash. That is, we are doing more heating. This is the condition of saturated vapor. When we are having the more suction line, when we are having the more suction lines, so this one is shifted on the 1 dash, because refrigerant is taking the heat from the atmosphere, and because of the length is increasing, so superheating is carried out. So one point is shifted on 1 dash. We are not changing any condenser pressure and evaporator pressure. So the compression work is 1 to 2 dash. So this one is advisable or not advisable. That is the point. As we know, if you are doing only superheating, the compression work is increasing. You are not getting any effect of the refrigerating effect. You are not getting any increasing in the refrigerating effect. So this is not advisable. Only by doing only superheating. What is advisable? If you are doing the superheating with the subcooling, it is advisable in the simple VCRS. So that we discuss today about the different factor which is affected on the performance of the VCRS. First we discuss the effect of the evaporator pressure, then we effect of the subcooling, then we discuss effect of the condenser pressure and effect of the superheating. It is already asked many times in the G2 examination. Also, it is asked in the MCQs, multiple choice questions. So it is very much important question for the thermal engineering to refrigeration chapter. Thank you.